Oh, yeah. What's up, Wopsters? I'm not better, but I'm more medicated because Womp Up the Jams, Womp It Up. I'm on a shit of Sudafed, and it's rushing through my blades like a bunch of smack.
It's rushing through your blades? What did you say?
I said running through my veins.
Oh, I thought you said running through your blades.
Do you think they stopped Jay-Z in the middle of his recordings to say, hey, Jay-Z, we didn't understand that lyric?
Probably.
No, you know why?
Because he'd be enunciated.
Like, fuck you guys.
And then he puts it in his music, and the second take is even better. Ready? Want to start from the get-go?
I know. Who produces Jay-Z? That's a real chicken and the egg.
His mother.
Produces himself.
Nailed it.
Womp up the jams, womp it up. Thinking a lot about Jay-Z and Beyonce. If they can work their shit out, we all should be able to. Right? I'm using my art to work through my issues. And today, those issues are daylight savings time.
I hate daylight savings. Why do we do it if we don't work as farmhands?
Okay.
I don't have to go wake
Farmer's
up to milk.
Farmer's almanac showed up today for work.
Come milk a cow.
We stopped. Okay, tell everybody what they're listening to.
What's up, Wopsters? This is Marissa Wompler. My name is Marissa Wompler.
Yeah, you said that already. Uh-huh.
Again.
Yep.
What would Jay-Z do if one of the people who works for him, which technically you do when I'm on this podcast, because you are my co-host.
No.
I am the primary
host.
None
of this would exist without me. Just be honest.
None of this would
exist. You'd be like, let's throw it down on those cans, and you'd just be walking on the sidewalk.
Without Sam.
Nobody recording you.
None of this would exist without Sam.
Sam, I brought Sam in here because I couldn't work the music and work the guests and get you here and stay on task without someone else. So I found this amazing young man who's willing to dedicate his
time. Getters left us in the gutter.
That's true.
You know? Where is he? He hasn't shown up to work in like 4 weeks.
He doesn't work here.
What are you talking about? He's still a teacher at the Stars Academy.
Yeah, they went on a trip to Argentina.
He and Rodney?
They went on a field trip, yeah.
First of all, I thought Rodney had either, like, had that skin disorder had sent him back into the hospital. So that's where I've been sending him flowers, like, every 3 days.
No, you haven't.
I've been sending him an edible arrangement every 3 days.
Where are you getting money for an edible arrangement?
I'm putting it on Seth's credit card.
Who's got their cell phone on? Turn it off.
I don't. Why are you saying that?
It just went off.
I didn't hear it.
A ding a dong.
That's my pussy.
Okay. That is
when I'm ready for business.
No.
A ding a dong. It puts out a much like God. I saw the saddest nature documentary about the sloth.
Yeah.
There are these sloths on these islands, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're separated by water. Like, there's these tiny little atolls. And sometimes there's only one sloth on the little island, the mangroves. Mm-hmm. And so they'll put out a call like, ha-ha!
That's what a sloth sounds like?
Yes. And
sounds a lot like a peacock.
A male will hear it, right? And then it'll be like, shit, I got to get to that sloth because they only breed once a year, like for like a week.
Right.
And then they'll be like, shit.
Spend the entire year getting over to the other atoll.
Exactly. And sometimes they get over there, and it's not the right atoll, and it's another dude. And they're like, well, shit. And you know how they have to get there? They swim.
That must take forever.
It takes. Actually, they're very quick in the water, just like I am. I'm very good in the water.
You are?
That? Yeah.
Why aren't we doing our garbage runs in the water?
I don't know.
Why have I got you on? You know what?
What?
Gravity working against you.
Always.
We should have had that. We should have gotten you on one of those boards.
We should have get one of those anti-gravity chambers like Sandra Bullock had to train in for that movie.
Gravity?
Yeah.
Good point. What are we listening to?
You think they do each other up in space?
What are you talking about?
Do you think astronauts have sex up in space?
For sure.
Somebody's got to get their dong out and try it out up there.
For sure.
But guess what?
What do you think?
Tough stuff.
Dicks don't work in space?
I know they work, but that's tough because, A, where do you find the space?
It's space. What are you talking about?
I'm saying.
Sam likes it. Sam likes it.
That's what a sloth sounds like.
When it's an estrus. First of all, asshole. They have a very small space on the space station. Not on the space station. I'm talking about on the shuttle. And secondly,
how much space do you need to have sex? Not that much space.
But everybody's there. What, do they all watch?
You think they all are in one room together? Sleeping? They don't have their own private chambers?
No, they have like these sleeping pods, and you can't fit two people in there. And also,
what are you talking about?
Watch them.
What have you been watching, these sleeping pods? What is this based on? Apollo 13?
No, I saw
Star Trek Next Generation.
Hey, Google it, bitch. Also, have you seen them? Have you seen them?
Googling it.
Listen to me.
Can astronauts have
Don't
sex?
Don't Google that, because there's going to be some fan fiction about that. But Google how they, also, have you ever watched them brush their teeth? Water is like little actual solid balls of water. So mm-hmm. somebody jizzes, and that shit's floating around the space shuttle for the rest of the trip.
Well, you got to catch it just like you do in real life. What? You got to catch it or swallow it or suck it up into your lady parts, right? And then squeak it out later. Or it fertilizes an egg and we move on.org.
Wow, you're disgusting.
I wonder if you could get extra pregnant in space. Do you know what I mean? Because.
What?
Not extra pregnant, but if it helps. Because would
Why
it?
Why would it?
Because the little sperms like get extra help floating around in there. You know what I mean? If,
you're
not, if it's
just
like
floating?
Not in gravity.
I don't know. This is like, well, again.
Or maybe it's harder to get pregnant in space.
I'm sure somebody has done a test about what sperms are like in space, because if it involves a dick, then we're putting money towards it. You know what I'm saying?
Nope.
You know what I'm spraying?
Nope.
Millions of taxpayer dollars a year are put towards dick things about, how
Viagra.
Can we make a dick longer? You know,
Cialis.
Does this work? Yes, yeah, exactly. If this involves a woman, we ain't putting any money towards it.
Oh, no.
You know what I'm
Shut
saying?
Shut your mouth and sit in the corner.
Exactly. Anyway.
Take care of what's mine.
We digress. What was I saying?
Sure did. I would like for you to tell the listeners what they're listening to, just like a brief synopsis.
Got it.
And then we got to introduce our guest, because she's sitting over here quiet as a peach.
I know, but she's enjoying the shit out of it, which is nice, because this is such a nice break from Miss Anderson, that old crotchety bitch.
Oh, she's gone.
I hope her hip remains fractured for all of time. Thank you, osteoporosis.
Okay.
This podcast was brought to you by Boniva. That bitch broke her hip.
Okay.
All right. Because our guest is the new librarian. Okay. Guys, Marissa Wompler, don't know how old I am, but I am a senior at Marina Del Rey Public High School. This is my senior podcast project, Womp It Up. My co-host and ride or die, Charlotte Shardog Listler, also known as Miss Listler, is my teacher / soulmate at the Stars Academy, aka mm-hmm. Spaz Academy, an alternative learning program that takes place in the basement of the Marina Del Rey Public High School. I am currently the only student since Eric Gutterman Gutterballs has gone away with our other student, Rodney, to a 3-month, I don't know, wander yar in Bolivia or wherever the fuck they are in
Argentina.
South America, Argentina. Mm-hmm. And we just get involved in the people and the places of Marina Del Rey. We mm-hmm. peel back the layers.
Mm-hmm.
And today, I'm very excited about our guest.
Yeah.
She's a breath of fresh air.
That's the truth of it.
It is the new librarian here at Marina Del Rey Public High School, Miss Judy Toots. And before you laugh, that is a cute name that is for real, I guess. Miss Judy Toots.
Judy Toots.
That's right. Hi.
Hi.
Welcome.
I'm so excited to be here.
Well, we're recording from your own backyard. So.
Well, I know, and I hear all the buzz and all the buzz that's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
I'm so glad that I get to, you know, see what it's all about.
Well, we're so excited to have you, and thank you, because Miss Anderson, I gotta say, had a real bee upper bonnet about the fact we'd constructed a pup tent. In the
self-help
in the self-help section.
A pup tent.
That's
for puppy? What is it?
No, this is what we're under. We've hung a tarp, and that's a pup tent.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't know. Oh, my my goodness. Yep. That is so lovely.
Where did she come from? It's like meet me in St. Louis all over again with this woman.
Where are you originally from?
I'm from Edwin, Nebraska.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
That makes the Corn Belt.
That's right.
The Corn Belt.
Born and raised.
Not a lot of
there.
People from Nebraska.
No.
That you mean. No, they stay there usually.
No, that's right. Yeah, and I would have.
I could have. I can't wait to hear all about what brought you to Marina Del Rey. We're having a lot of people move to this great city, and I think that has a lot to do with the podcast.
Mm-hmm. It's on the water.
It is on the water, and it's a lovely, easy lifestyle.
Uh-huh.
Easy, breezy, beautiful. And were you a fan of Womp It Up before you came on this podcast?
You know, nope.
No. Hey, and I appreciate your honesty. That's the other thing you're going to get for people from the Midwest. They're honest.
They can't tell a lie.
The truth is I don't honestly know what a podcast is. You keep saying this word, and I'm like, what are we doing?
Okay. Uh-huh. Well, yeah, no, people can subscribe. They're going to listen to it. We've got a rabid fan base.
Rabid fan base?
Yeah, if you listen to
rabbit.
The rabbits?
Rabid.
Oh, rabid. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah. Although, I don't know, maybe some rabbits do listen to it.
Not on purpose.
Well, we have that cute little veterinarian clinic that keeps tweeting at us.
That's true.
They may put it on.
Cute!
That's true.
They may put it on to soothe. Maybe my voice, while it riles humans up, might calm animals down.
You should send them a picture of the pup tent. They'd get a kick out of that, I bet.
That's a good idea.
Again, has nothing to do with puppies. It's literally just a tarp.
Sometimes I'll listen back to the cat with my cat army.
Yeah, of course.
And they will calm down.
Wow, and that's crazy because they're really riled up.
Because I'm their chief in command.
Yeah, of course. How many cats do you have?
There's 87 in this current brigade. Whoa. Oh,
Miss Toots.
Wow.
Miss Toots.
That was too many cats for you.
Excuse me.
Miss Toots.
That just popped right out. Do you have
reflex. So that was a real reflex.
I just never had heard of that many cats.
No, and she lives.
Cats.
Do they live with you on the houseboat or are they, where? Here's my question. Some of them are rabid. They're stray cats. They live in the wild.
They were originally stray wild cats. Yes.
And you're trapping them.
Yeah.
And I know you had a problem with...
I'm taking them off the street. Most of them,
that's beautiful.
They didn't have a place to go, a place to call their own. And I know all about that since I don't have my own place where I lay my head every night because I'm a rambling man.
But what about the houseboat? Are you not that anymore?
No.
You were just squatting there?
Yeah.
Okay, got it.
They came back. That family came back.
Oh, okay.
So, So we kind of roam the streets.
Scooping all day, every day.
No, cats cover their poop. They go in a bed. They cover it. It fertilizes. It comes back full circle.
It fertilizes a bed. A human bed?
Oh, no, Miss Toots.
She doesn't
know. No, like a bed, like a growing bed, like a gardening bed or
no,
a bed
of
flowers or a bed of bushes.
Of course.
No, she's living. This is what I picture when you're sleeping outside.
Yeah.
Do you cover yourself with those cats?
Pretty much.
Like a fur coat.
I mean, I can't.
Made of cats?
I don't pull them up to my neck and tuck in, underneath.
But they do that on their own.
But they do that on their own. They like to be close. Oh, it's almost as if they're coming home to nurse, like on my 12 teats.
Right, but they're not nursing.
They're not nursing.
No.
That would be insane. So let's get into our hot topics, or have we already done that?
No, God, no. How have we done that? I haven't talked about anything except for the sloth, the mating habits of a sloth.
Well,
and can you jerk off in space?
We've been talking for a long time.
Yeah, but that's not hot topics, is what's going on with us.
I see.
Don't try to avoid it. Do you have something you want to avoid talking about?
Wow.
Okay, because all you're talking about is cats and all that. It's like,
why did you say it like that?
Well, my point is, it's interesting to me that almost every podcast you try to move past hot topics. And you know why? Because what would happen if you took off the protective coverlet of cats that you've got, proverbially on your heart?
I think it's proverbially.
Proverbially. Thank you, Miss Toots. Mm-hmm. On your body. Okay?
Yeah. Uh-huh. She should have a better command of words. Am I right? metaphor. She's a librarian.
Da-dee-da-dee-da.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Looking at the book title.
See, no, it's not very challenging to get a job as a librarian at a public high school.
You do have to have a degree in it, library science.
Really?
Normally. Do you think maybe she wasn't a librarian before? We're going to get into
it. Is that a recognizable Okay, sorry about that. We're back online.
Hi.
Music, man. What were you just singing, Miss Toots?
Oh, sometimes I just make up songs,
that's
you know.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
You're in the library here alone most of the time because nobody
right.
comes in here.
No.
Because everyone's reading on a Kindle these days or downloading
no.
it.
Mm-hmm. And kids, kids, students don't.
They
are they going to get a book for?
They don't read.
You know?
No, no. And I've forgotten how to read. So it's nice to be around these things, but it feels to me like I'm like a traveler back in time, you know? And I'm like, what are these words, you know?
Oh, like a Rosetta Stone.
Like a Rosetta Stone type of thing. Someday I might relearn. But as of now, Listler told me I don't need to know the English language. And I just am going to use my senses to kind of smell out
you have a,
success.
A great command of it already.
Exactly.
Yeah.
At any rate, let's go to Hot Topics, okay?
Sounds good.
All right. You going to play a song or are we just going to? Okay. Ooh. Miss Toots likes this one.
Oh,
she's really
loose.
She's really grooving.
I'm tooting out.
You call that the toot?
This is the toot. It's a hot toot. Ooh, I like that toot.
Welcome to Hot Topics. This is where we just talk briefly about mm-hmm. what's going mm-hmm. on in our lives. Liz, you want to go first?
Nope.
All right.
What do you want to talk about?
No, I want to ask you a couple questions, okay? I'm going to put you on the hot seat for just 1 second.
All right. Can't wait for these Sudafed-fueled questions
okay.
to come at me.
What is the status of you and Kareem?
Because
I've asked you to have him on the show a couple times.
Yep.
And you've been very evasive.
Yep. He's not here.
And yet, I found a 3/4 empty container of Lebna, which we know is a Middle Eastern yogurt
mm-hmm.
in your satchel the other day.
Okay. Why were you going through my satchel?
Because I have to do these things to find clues to see what's going on in your interior life. Otherwise,
no,
all
don't.
I hear about
that's
are these fucking
cats. That's not my interior life. That's my exterior life.
Well,
that's my exterior
you don't eat
life.
Lebna.
Yes, I do.
And you can't find it anywhere here. So somebody imported it.
A mini fridge stocked with all of Kareem's favorite foods for when he should feel like.
Where do you have
a
mini fridge plugged in? You don't live anywhere.
Oh, you can plug it in anywhere.
There's an outlet, right?
You can plug it in any outlet. It's
yeah.
true.
Okay, well, where do you have access to an outlet if you're living on the street?
The walk-in and Jersey Mike's.
Your relationship with these guys is getting too enmeshed.
It's a win-win for them, to be honest. To be
why?
Cahoots,
what are
I
you
protect
doing?
The store. There's a lot of big bang companies coming in trying to take over.
Oh, I thought
they're
you meant like
put in
stars
a condo.
Of Big Bang Theory were coming in.
Well.
Are they?
Is Melissa Rauch coming in a lot? The one who played the little one who plays Bernadette?
She loves she's from Jersey. She loves a Jersey Mike's.
Is that right?
Sub, because it's authentic. And these guys, they go off menu. They'll go off menu.
No.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be saying that on the air.
Why not?
Because they
get
could get
more,
shut down for
they're
that.
They're not going to get shut down.
What
it's a franchise thing. They don't have to follow any
really?
Rules. Yeah, they could do whatever the
how do
they want.
How do they go off menu? What do you have to say?
You go in and you just tell them what you want. You want a hot hoagie? You want a hot Italian pastrami?
They'll do it.
Yeah,
even
yeah.
if it's not on the menu.
That's right.
Wow.
They got everything you could ever imagine.
You know what? I would love to get myself off my pizza diet and maybe roll into a hoagie diet. You know what I mean? I feel like
sure.
that would give me more variety. And also, these guys and Jersey Mike's feels like that might be the partnership we're looking for.
Well, I mean, you're folding a pizza in half, sandwiching cream cheese. That
I'm already
is essentially
doing it.
A hoagie.
I'm already doing
yeah.
it.
Yeah, exactly.
This is a great idea. I'm going to start what I'm going to call
you're
a
welcome.
Jersey Mike's diet. And I'm going to try it for 2 weeks. And
you're
we're going to see, do I
come.
Lose weight? Do I gain weight? How do I feel energy level
yeah,
wise?
Yeah, we're going to hit the pool, clearly, because we've been missing out on the pool.
I'm like a manatee. You put a manatee on the on the earth, on yeah. the dry land.
The most gentle creatures.
That shit's going to just dry up
Isn't
in the sun.
Isn't that crazy? You put a manatee next to one, a sloth, and they race, and a sloth is going to be faster?
100%.
I would not have bet on that.
Listeners, do yourself a favor and Google sloth swimming. These guys are just going at it because they've got those claws.
I would never, ever have thought of that.
Those long, they do go fast. They do. Miss Toots.
What?
They do.
No, they fucking don't.
Uh-oh.
I mean.
What's your hot topics, Tootsie?
Oh, well.
Toots and the Maytals, what's your hot topics?
Well, as you both know, I'm new.
Yes. How many weeks have you been here in Marina Del Rey?
3 weeks.
3 weeks. Loving so you're setting up your moment. Spot. And are you married, single? What's
you know
the story?
You know what? That's so funny you should ask. I was.
Okay.
Not technically supposed to talk about it, but I was.
Oh, why is that? A legal thing or?
Yeah. See, I'm in the witness protection program. And
what?
I was relocated to Marina Del Rey from Edwin, Nebraska.
Uh-huh. I think you're not technically
are you supposed to talk
that?
About that?
Well, oh, fluff. My real name is Geraldine Freakit.
Oh, God. Oh, no. What?
Toots. Let's, we're going to.
Geraldine
we
Freakit.
We can't edit this out.
F-R-E-A-K-I-T.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Like the verb, but one word.
Okay, freak it, Geraldine, freak it. Can you do me?
What's the verb?
Okay.
What's the verb?
The verb is freak it.
I've never can you use that
use
in,
it
a,
in
sentence?
A sentence.
Okay.
Use it
Martha
in...
had to freak it the laundry machine.
What does that mean?
You know what it means.
We don't. I thought it was going to be like, hey, I hit the dance floor and got real freak it doing the toots.
No.
Martha
it's a verb.
Had to freak it the laundry machine. Does that mean like when you sit on top of a dryer and you get yours?
Yeah. Yeah, freak it. Oh, no. Okay, fine. Here's another one.
Great. I'm going to diagram this. Mm-hmm, okay? Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Tell me.
Lucas. Went on a drive.
Okay, and do this at home, too, so in case I miss it. I went mm-hmm. on a drive, yeah, uh-huh.
And then he got to his favorite spot.
Oh, this is so long.
And okay. he freak it.
And he parked there?
No.
That doesn't
and
work.
He freak it.
That means he got on a washing machine.
That's
there.
Right. In the middle of a field.
And
which is his favorite.
Wait, he
spot.
Freak it. He jerked it.
I mean freak it.
Masturbation specific to a washing machine.
That's right. It's subjective, but it is a verb and it is specific and it has a definition. And I can't be any clearer.
Okay, and we won't ask you to because I'm frankly very confused. I want to just be very clear.
Uh-huh.
This podcast is going to be listened to.
Yes, I know
by
we know you
humans,
don't know what a podcast
maybe
is.
Maybe animals.
Well, if there were a reason for you to be in the witness protection program, mm-hmm. i.e. you saw something and
sure
people
did.
Would kill you.
A murder. Oh. I saw a murder.
Oh,
it was a
no.
mob hit.
Okay.
By a mob.
Okay.
By the mob, I should say, not a big group of people.
How did you
by
know it was mob. The mob?
Wait, before we go forward,
this
I just
so
want to be very clear that we can stop this podcast right now. You can walk out that door.
We don't have to air this.
We will have to air it up till now.
Okay.
But then we don't have to record any further.
No, I'm having fun. Please.
I know, but you might be murdered.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Look, I'm in Marina Del Rey. I'm a librarian at a high school. Who's going to find out?
Well, that's
you
the
know?
Thing. Maybe mobsters don't listen to podcasts.
Well, I'm sure they don't. They're too busy curbing people.
Mm-hmm. You don't know what that means.
What is it? People are just like,
it's
get out of my car.
It's when you pull people over.
Uh-huh.
And you freak it.
Okay. Again, I don't, I'm so
I mean, that's
confused.
My understanding of curbing. What's uh-huh. yours?
I'm not going to describe it. It would be really disturbing and we
okay.
wouldn't be able to have any comedy after
I'm
that.
I'm so sorry. Miss Toots, what do you want me to call you now? Your real
oh,
name?
Oh, you can call me Toots. I kind of like it. But please, I just want you to know that my full name is Geraldine Augustine Freak It.
Okay.
And Freak It, of course, is my married name.
Oh.
Your maiden name was?
My maiden name was... Fart.
Oh, no.
This isn't true.
No. It's a lie. It was splooge. And
Geraldine Augustine Splooge
yeah.
is what you were born as?
That's right.
Oh,
Oh, my God. Is this like a Fargo situation? You were just in the wrong place at the wrong time, maybe.
You know, I tell you what. I was married to the wrong man. I was married to Randolph Freakett, mm-hmm. who had a gambling problem, I'm not ashamed to say.
Oh, gosh. That's
he
tough.
He borrowed...
That's tough stuff.
He borrowed so much money from the mafia. I'm talking Joey the Hat... Guadagnelli.
Your name and names.
Now, why was he called the Hat? Do you know?
He always wore a hat.
Oh, okay. Got it.
Seems simple enough.
Got it.
Frankie Bloody Nose Malcolms.
That's not even Italian. Wow. And Bloody Nose, that's what he would give people?
No,
always had a nosebleed problem?
No.
What was it that... We don't know why he was called
that?
We
don't know.
Oh, okay.
What was Joey's last name? Botticelli or something?
Guanicelli.
That sounds a lot like what's in Mucinex.
That's what right.
Guanicelli.
And then, of course, Tony up top, Fallandini. Yeah,
Tony
those are
up
the
top.
Three guys. Tony, that they run the local chapter or whatever of the Edwin mob.
And he got in trouble with them.
There's a mafia in Edwin, Nebraska.
They're everywhere. That's my point.
Was your husband the one that was murdered?
Yes. I witnessed my husband being buried alive in our backyard.
Oh, my God.
Sweet Jesus. All right, we got to...
Wait a second.
All right, listen. We have to take a break.
I just want to be very clear. This is going to be a fucking fascinating podcast.
I know, but it could get her.
What would Barbara Walters do?
La, 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 la.
She'd do the interview. She's looking for rate. It sweeps.
It sweeps.
Because it's sweeps week for podcasts right now. And we got to beat one person, and that's fucking Scott Aukerman, that piece of shit.
Yeah. Choctaw. All right. Well,
it's sweeps week. We got
to
do
it. Do you have anything
it.
You want to talk about for Hot Topics? Because if you don't, let's go to a break.
I don't really have much, except for my Jersey Mike's diet, which I just came up
with.
You
want to talk anything about daylight savings, or are we done with that?
I want to save that for what's cheesing me.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
All right. All right. We're going to go to a break. Okay.
Best trained, best educated, best equipped. Best
what is this?
Fight the power.
What?
Public enemy, fight the power.
What's the connection?
What do you mean, what's the connection?
Miss Toots is fighting the power? Oh, no, she's dancing again.
I just wanted her to groove again.
I gotta tell you, though, for somebody who witnessed her husband being buried alive,
yeah.
She has a lot of joie de vivre, doesn't she?
She didn't like him.
Oh, with a name like Freak It.
It's a hot toot.
It's gotta be.
We gotta get a video of this and post it online. This is wild. This is wild. What a loose pelvis she has, right? Wow.
Hey, I'm Hari Kundabolu.
And I'm Ashok Kundabolu.
We're the Kundabolu Brothers, and we're excited to tell you about our new podcast on Earwolf, Kundabolu Brothers Podcast. It's a live podcast where we discuss some of the harder issues of the day.
You will be witnessing two brothers talking to each other and occasionally acknowledging the audience.
We discuss such topics as World War I, Kenan Thompson, pizza. We're excited for you to listen to Kundabolu Brothers every Thursday on Earwolf. And don't forget to subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, or wherever you like to listen.
What is this? Some like Run DMC?
It actually is.
Oh, shit.
Yes, it is. Good call. No.
Toot. She's beatboxing? Welcome back, everybody, to Womp It Up. This is Marissa Wompler and Charlotte Shardar Glister. We're here with our new librarian, Geraldine Augustine Splooge, nay, Freak It.
No, not. You've done this twice in a row. It's Nay Splooge. Her married name is Freak It. Nay is French for born.
Oh, I thought it was married. Okay.
No. That's what I said to Randolph. I said, you better Nay Splooge.
Oh, no.
What?
I'm starting to think this woman got everything she deserved.
Okay.
We know her as Judy Toots, Miss Judy Toots, our new librarian. She's in the witness protection program. She definitely shouldn't be speaking to us, but she is, and we're going to go with it because it's sweeps week, as we said. And we just have no other choice. So here we go. Miss Toots, we had gotten to something pretty salacious before the break, and that was that you witnessed your husband being buried alive by the mafia.
Yeah.
And that is what led you to be in the witness protection
program.
That's
exactly right, because I witnessed a mob hit. Like, they were going after him because my husband was $75,000 in debt, and he couldn't pay that back.
That doesn't sound like...
It seems like you could get a home equity loan for something
that seem like that much money. I mean, for murder. Maybe he did something else.
No. It was just the money, and they weren't having it. So Joey, Frankie, and Tony all came over to our house one morning.
Right.
And
in the morning. You 10 a.m. If you're going to bury someone alive, you do it at night.
Nope. 10 a.m. I think they wanted me to see, quite frankly.
I guess everybody was gone to work, so no one would hear the screams.
That's right. And I don't work until now.
I'm not surprised about that.
Yeah.
This woman's grip on reality is tenuous.
Are you familiar with the Dewey Decimal
system? Mm-hmm. That's what I was thinking
about. You put a number, you do it. It's easy.
This is what I told you about college and why I don't have to go. Who calls a reference? Honestly, I'm going to put on my resume, Yale, graduated Yale, graduated Howard University.
Anybody that would be worth their weight in anything is going to call a reference.
Yeah, they do. I'd love to hear from our listeners. Has anyone in the position of hiring somebody ever called a school to say, did this person go?
Yes, they do.
Oh, really? Then why is the biopic Younger where that Sutton Foster pretends to be a young woman even though she's 65 years old?
That's not a biopic.
Nobody called her references, and she's best friends with Hillary Duff.
Have you been watching Younger?
Yes.
Isn't it pronounced biopic?
I don't know. Is it? What is it?
I think it is.
Biopic?
Mm-hmm. According to the Dewey Decimal System, it's true.
Now she's going to lose her job. So let's move away from librarian terms.
Sure.
At any rate, so it's the morning.
Yeah.
They come over. You offer them coffee.
I offer them cookies.
Okay, you offer them cookies. They come over. It's 10 a.m.
You want cookies?
Right, because that's all you're doing these days is you're cooking, you're making up treats.
Yeah, I'm making treats, I'm cooking, I'm baking, I'm just filling my days.
Filling your days, okay. No kids.
No kids.
Thank
goodness. That's what I say, nay splooge. Randolph really wanted kids, but I couldn't figure out how to do it. I just couldn't wrap my mind around, how are you gonna do that?
What do you mean?
You never had sex with your husband?
Oh, please. We freaked it, but...
With the washing machine. In the back seat of your car. That's what it is. It's have sex. That's what freak it means.
No, that's not what freak it means.
Okay. She said we freaked it.
Yeah. Freak it
is
something
different. It's a
separate thing.
Oh, God. I was so
close. So we freaked it. And, of course we did. But it was just something that I couldn't see myself as a mother. I don't know if...
I understand that. You know, I feel the same. I don't need to have kids.
No, never.
I don't think so.
I think you'd be a great mom.
Really?
Yeah.
That means so much to me.
Yeah.
It's just that everything that has come into my, I can't keep a plant alive. I remember that gerbil I had that I rolled over on in the night and it
slept in the bed with you?
Yeah, in my arrow bed. The bummer of that is that's why I have a hole in it, because it gnawed in there.
Because of the gerbs?
Yeah, because of the gerbs. Well, Seth got it for me because I was, bitching about the fact that nobody would touch me in my house and I needed something to hang on to. Mm-hmm. And so I slept with it in my bed, but it gnawed a hole in the arrow bed and actually squeezed its way through, because much like a rat, I don't have to tell you this, Liz, because you eat them breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Yeah.
It actually can squeeze itself into a very small space.
Oh, they can
what gerbils are known for,
flatten
right?
themselves.
That's
they
exactly,
can truly it flattened themselves.
That's exactly right. So it got in through the hole, and it was running around tickling me at night. My under
from
regions.
The underneath. Yeah.
But oh, as no. you know.
That's sort of like a vibrating bed.
That's exactly
for, but
right.
a lot cheaper.
That's right.
Not but a quarter. Once you make a hole in an aero bed, what's going to happen?
The air is going to come out of it.
Slowly but surely.
And I fell into a deep slumber, and I woke up, and what it felt like was that I was on a bit of a waterbed, and that actually was its insides.
Oh.
Because gerbils are 95% water.
Right. But
no.
But
it burst,
even.
It burst like a tiny.
Even if it were
like
a
tiny water balloon,
fully made of water, that's not enough to support an entire aero bed. That would have just gotten shot. You would have hit the floor for sure.
There was fluid, is what I mean, and I felt so bad, mm-hmm. and but there was no way to clean it out. So anyway, wow. That's why there's that smell.
Got it.
All right.
Well. Here we are.
Mm. So
at any rate, you're there.
I'm making sorry, I digress. So I offered cookies. Randolph is up in the tub.
Mm-hmm.
He takes a bath every morning.
That's weird. At like 10 a.m.?
Yeah.
Doesn't he? Well, he's not working either because he's spending most of his money at the track and whatever.
That's right. Mm-hmm. He's a novelist, though. So he sort of, I know.
Yeah, right. What? Sounds like you weren't really that very supportive of his career.
I just thought it was... I just
enough
thought it
is
was
enough.
Exactly. It felt so indulgent
right.
and dumb.
So but he made enough money to put a roof over your head, right, and put food
best
on the table.
Bestseller, number one, week after week.
Was it a thriller? Did he write thrillers? Or?
No. He wrote romance novels.
Oh, interesting. Under a pseudonym? Or?
No.
He went under Randolph Freakit. Oh my God! We got to get some of his titles.
I haven't. Yeah.
Do you
of
carry some of them here in the library?
They probably.
Oh,
too.
You know, we probably do. I should go look. They're pretty. I mean, they're pretty. Salacious.
Oh, Sam's raising his hand. Ugh. Probably
Sam
jerked it
some.
To Sam. Has
backpack.
Some. I'm not surprised about that.
Yeah, he has some in his backpack.
What are some of the titles?
We have.
Oh no!
Oh God! Great.
Turn your mic on.
Sorry, I forgot my mic was off. We have Death Comes First, The Splooge.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
They're,
yeah.
Wait, they're
was
like,
that a mis- like a murder mystery?
No. That was a romance novel.
Death Comes First, colon, The mm-hmm. Splooge?
But it's written out, colon, The Splooge.
Oh.
Oh, no. Gross. Yeah. That's uh-huh. the one you're currently reading?
Well, they're all mystery novels. There's Who Freaked It?
Mm. They're mystery. Now, he's reading it as a mystery.
Well,
but you're saying
it as a romance.
Okay. That says a lot about your
this
taste.
This is how you love
romance.
People.
I guess.
It's through violence and danger.
And there's one more, and this really looks like a bodice ripper.
Mm-hmm. It just says, shh.
Oh, no. Me too. Okay.
Oh, man.
All right. Thank you,
all right,
Sam.
All right. Thanks, Sam.
That is terrifying.
Yeah. Shh. Well, he was really whatever. He got by. So anyway, he's in the bathtub. They say, we got to go upstairs. So they go upstairs. They pull him out of the bathtub.
Surprised they wouldn't just drown him right then and there. Well,
that seems like it would be a quicker
death.
Yeah,
and also not one that you need to like cover up. Somebody
then you
slips.
Have to get, then you have to get a dead weight, wet body out of the house.
That feels like you've
backyard.
Done that before.
It's tough stuff. I mean, unless you got an army of cats, how are you going to carry it?
Hey,
you know what I mean?
Hey, you're not going to tell me that a bunch of cats can carry a dead body. Not possible.
What do you mean? If they all align.
Oh, yeah. If the weight's distributed, yeah.
Okay. Please don't.
Light as a feather, stiff as a board.
We have one person on this podcast who is 100% going to get murdered after this. Let's not have you also... incriminate yourself.
I'm not incriminating myself. I'm just saying.
You just said you've had experience with carrying
I
a
didn't
dead,
say
wet
anything.
Body with-
Geraldine Augustine Freakit. My address currently
no!
is 522.
You know what we're going to do?
All right.
We're going to go to our What's Cheesing You segment. Do you know about this?
I can use context clues and put it together.
Let's tell her
what
it is. Let's tell her what it is.
It's not your favorite cheese, okay?
This is a segment unofficially sponsored by Jersey Mike's, by their hot panini press. cheese yourself today with a all cheese sub that is pressed and melted. Do they make that? They should.
They should.
All cheese.
You could order it at the Marina Del Rey Jersey, Mike. They'll let you have anything you want.
Shout out to Ralph Macchio.
What cheese in you? What cheese in you? What? What cheese in you? What cheese in you? What cheese in you? What? What cheese in you? How?
What's cheesing you?
I just wanted to clarify. I said shout out to Ralph Macchio because Ralph Macchio, the actor known for Karate Kid, his son is actually the owner of the franchise that we're talking about. Is that correct?
Yes. I guess.
What do you mean? You thought that there was just random that a guy named Ralph Macchio was owned that place? You know that guy, Ralph?
We all call him Junior. So yeah, I didn't know his name.
He's severely overweight.
I didn't know Ralph. I didn't know his name was Ralph Macchio. Mm-hmm. We just call him Junior.
Anyway, that's another reason to stop by the Marina Del Rey Jersey Mike's.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is a segment, Miss Toots, where we talk about what's bothering us currently.
Yummy.
And it's just like kind of like,
Yummy.
All right. So what's bothering us right now in the world? You want to hit it with daylight savings?
Sure. All right. Here's what's cheesing me, okay? And it's been cheesing me for a long time. Daylight savings. We don't need it. Here's what I want to do, okay? I want to return to the time the Pocahontas lived, okay? You think they fucking turned their clocks back, bitch? No, they didn't. Okay, they would be like, oh, the days are getting longer naturally. I'm waking up later naturally or earlier naturally. Okay, this throws up off our rhythms. And today I woke up in time, what I thought was time to get to our garbage runs. Mm-hmm. I threw on a pair of Umbros. I was so proud of myself, right? I look at the clock. It's 11:30 a.m.
Right.
That's 5 hours past when I was supposed to meet you.
Right. Well, daylight savings is only 1 hour difference. It doesn't matter. More than that.
My body clock was thrown off.
Well, I mean, in the Pocahontas days, if we're going to use that as our example, they didn't have clocks, right?
Right.
So
they were living off the land.
Well, they wouldn't have said, you need to meet me here at 8:30.
They would say, when the crow calls twice, that's when we meet.
No, but there would be something that happens at the same time. Every day.
Right.
Right?
Right. That's my point.
Right.
So here I am. It's 12:30.
And you just have more or less time in a day to get your stuff done, right?
I had to eat 5 meals to make up for the meals I lost. What? Right? From all this time change, I had to eat my breakfast, lunch, dinner from the day before. I'm stuffed.
I'm confused.
I'm stuffed.
Did you sleep through 2 days?
It's the time change.
No.
Okay?
I don't think we can blame this on an hour shifting.
I got my period like 3 weeks early. Mm-hmm. So I'm just like, I'm all out of sorts and I blame it on daylight savings. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm over it. Okay?
Okay.
Unless you got a cow you need to milk, okay? We don't need it. That's Trump is doing this to us. Yes, it is. You know Obama wanted to abolish it. But then they turned it back in Congress, and they said, no, and let's bring it back to the floor, okay?
You're using a lot of metaphors, a lot of different references.
I'm not
sure they all go together into
That's
one
how
coherent.
Pissed I am. So if anyone wants to do a letter-writing campaign, let me know,
okay?
All right?
All right, here's what's cheesing me, and then we're going to ask you, Toots, okay? I've been teaching a parachute class with some toddlers in behind the Jersey Mics.
Sure.
And
that was your cheese of last week as well.
Well, it was about the parents giving me shit because we did an impromptu surgery on a cat. Anyway, they thought that the kids couldn't handle it. Here's what I'm saying.
We're back on the same thing.
It's not the same thing. It's a different thing. Okay. I had two different kids, and I had one kid as a hugger. Wants to hug the shit out of every other kid, right?
And the cats, too?
Yeah, sure, the cats, right? But what I'm worried about is setting appropriate boundaries for children,
right?
Okay?
Right.
Now, give a hug. That's fine. Let's learn. We're all going to take hugs.
Right.
If a child doesn't want a hug, the child needs to learn. We don't give hugs to that child.
Right.
We don't then try to give kisses to that child as well. Or tackle them with a neck hug. Okay. And so when I separate them, and then the parent said, you know what? If he's rejected, he just goes stronger. I'm like, you know what that is? The starts of a psychopath. So let's get those children some proper boundaries.
Hugging. Let's get kids to stop hugging.
And let's get them back to what they should be doing, watching, you know, videos of sloth swimming or you know, seeing a cat be just dissected.
Right.
So anyway.
So you want kids to stop hugging.
Nope, that's not what I said.
If you want to start your own letter writing campaign, good luck. Toddlers against hugging.
Okay. What?
But she's not a toddler.
Thank you.
Oh, Toots, now you're making fucking sense. Don't throw shade at me.
She's not
my own
a toddler.
Segment.
She's an adolescent.
Don't throw shade on my own segment, honey.
I'm an adolescent.
Okay.
Praise you. Praise you.
All right. Toots, turning over the mic.
What's cheesing you, Toots?
Toot, toot. Well, what's cheesing Toots here is, I gotta tell ya, my pantyhose. I can't make heads or tails of it.
You're still wearing pantyhose.
Hey,
yeah. Where do you get pantyhose in a Marina Del Rey?
With a light jean. She's wearing, just so you guys know, she's wearing a denim, like an acid washed jean.
Yeah.
High waisted.
Yummy.
With pantyhose beneath.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And a white kitten heel pump. That's a look. Now, why the pantyhose? Why can't we see your ankles? Are they also in the witness protection program?
No. I mean, I find it, pantyhose makes everything feel so smooth when you put it in.
That's what Randolph Freakit said.
Well,
oh, no, it was never smooth when he put it in.
Why?
I'd chop at it and stuff.
What do you mean?
I thought maybe you...
Chop at it!
I thought his penis was similar to the bark of a silk floss tree.
What do you mean you chopped at it?
Well, we would just... It's just our form of playing. I just, you know...
Like karate... She's making the motion of karate chopping it.
Yeah, I just play with it a little bit.
But
it was rough.
Bat it away?
It was rough. Yeah, it was
Wow, not a lot of men like that, but he was into some dangerous shit, that's obvious.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. $75,000.
It's not that much.
Debt.
I feel like if I had to go fund me $75,000, I could probably do that within a couple days, right?
Yeah, probably.
Anyway,
well,
he's dead now, so
he's dead
now. Help him.
I ran out of the house and nothing but a dish towel.
Oh, God. Wait, why were you naked?
You
were serving them cookies.
You bake naked?
So
you bake naked?
Three mobsters in your house. Your husband is upstairs in a bathtub. You're naked in the kitchen baking.
This is very suspicious, Toots.
While they're burying your husband alive in the backyard, you ran outside.
Well, because I was panicking.
Nothing but a diff towel. Is that what you're saying?
No, well, hold on. I answered the door. I was fully clothed. And then they said they wanted cookies, and so I started making the cookies, but it got too hot in the kitchen.
Come on, man.
What, man?
Are you trying
You're
to
telling
use
me
your
you don't
body?
Get hot?
I listen to me. This is very suspicious. I'm the police. I'm showing up. There's a woman naked.
I'm screaming.
They're using you. That's what's happening. They're using you.
Why?
Flip City.
They can't find me. I'm running down the street.
No,
dish
the
towel.
Police,
nothing but a dish towel.
They're using you to flip these three mobsters so that they can shut the door on that. But I know you were in bed with somebody.
Flip mobsters?
Who were you having sex with amongst the three of them?
Randolph Freakin.
No, you tell me. One of those mobsters.
Joey
you
the had, Hat.
Again. So easy.
But just a little?
No, what does that mean, just a little? Listen, I get it. I am totally attracted to Tony Soprano. Totally attracted.
Yeah,
yes.
Me too.
Yes.
In every...
A man in charge. A man I can go, I want this much. I got to go shopping. Give me this much.
Oh, you're...
Good fellas.
You're into
that
his
turns
command
me on.
Of money.
Yes.
You don't care where it comes from.
Paulie Walnuts?
You're attracted to Paulie Walnuts?
Paulie Walnuts.
I want to get some pomade and just grease back that hair, you know, and zip down that athletic leisure suit he's wearing.
But you don't want to be married to that person. You want to be
I
want to
have a... Yeah, exactly. So I get it, but that puts you in an interesting position.
Who's flipping who? What?
Okay. So
wait a minute. Who are you saying is flipping who?
You.
The cops
you're
are
being
flipping
used.
Me?
Yes. You're being used. You're probably being used right now. They know that the mob's going to come for you.
And what are they going to do?
Well, they're going to give you information. Are you wired?
Well, yeah.
Oh.
They told me to wear it every day.
Okay.
Tommy
contacted you since
Tommy
you moved?
Or Tony?
Tony the Hat? Tommy?
No, Joey the Hat.
Joey the Hat. Has Joey contacted you since you've moved to Marina?
Of course, we talk on a landline.
Oh.
Specifically a landline.
Does he know it's a landline?
I don't know what he does or doesn't know. All I know is my pantyhose are really cheesing me.
Okay. Thank you for your honesty.
Because they make things too smooth?
Yeah, it's too smooth. It's too slippery. All right, I feel like I'm just sliding around in my kitten heels. But what else am I supposed to do?
We're going to a break, okay?
God. This is complicated, right?
Yeah.
Someone's got to option this woman's story. Because this would be a great one,
we
right?
We should do it.
I feel like
we?
Frances McDormand would be a great, this would be a great star vehicle for her. Not that she needs it.
I'll star in it.
Well. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
She'd never bother.
We'll be back in a few minutes.
That's why the lady
with Womp It Up.
Is a tramp.
Hi, I'm Cameron Esposito.
And I'm Maria Butcher.
And we're stoked to bring our long-running stand-up podcast, Put Your Hands Together, to Earwolf.
Yay!
Every week we record PYHT live here at the UCB Theater in Los Angeles.
Recently, we've had sets or chats from folks like Sarah Silverman and Hari Kondabolu.
We've had Earwolf faves like Paul F. Tompkins, James Adomian, Nicole Byer. It's the opportunity to be at a live stand-up show hosted by two wives in your ears, wherever you live. You can listen or subscribe right now on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, or earwolf.com.
Welcome back to Womp It Up. This is one of the most salacious podcasts we've ever had. If you haven't tuned in, this is like an episode of How to Get Away with Murder.
Yeah, that right? Song was called How I Could Just Kill a Man.
Exactly. And here, just like Shonda Rhimes, our queen, It's got twists and turns. You're thinking, who's in the rug? Okay? Well, I'll tell you who's not in the rug yet. Miss Judy Toots.
Nope.
Won't be long, though.
Won't be long.
I
literally, when we first started this podcast, I thought to myself, she's innocent. This poor woman, a victim of a husband gambling. Mm-hmm. Okay, she had to watch him get buried alive. Mm-hmm. Then we find out she's in an affair with a notorious.
No, just a little bit.
That's again.
Just a little bit of sex. You can't.
That's still an affair.
You put just the tip in.
It's still an affair.
Still an affair.
You lick his cheek. Still an affair.
With Joey the Hat.
You have him put on your pantyhose and dance around like Buffalo Bill. Still.
Hey! Don't! You God damn it, Listler! I swear to God I'd forgotten that scene. Fuck you!
Still an affair.
Is she wearing pantyhose in that? Now I'm remembering that scene and I feel legitimately sick.
I don't think he had anything.
No, he's
on
not wearing pantyhose.
That's
robe.
Not funny and not cool.
It just was
just
a tuck.
Tucked in there. Yeah.
Oh, I literally feel sick. I feel sick to my stomach. I hate you so much.
All right,
much.
Well, let's do some questions then from listeners.
Now I'm in a terrible headspace.
You already were.
I am trying to forget
that
movie.
How many Sudafed had you taken before you came in here?
Frame by frame by frame.
All right, this is Listler's Love Lockdown, where we answer your questions and sometimes your opinions, because everybody's got an opinion. Get your own fucking podcast if you want to weigh in.
Nobody's giving us an opinion.
Well, listen to this asshole. Stavros. This guy has a last
Greek.
Name.
Well, he's pissed off. Look at what's happening for Greece right now.
Well, if...
I don't know, but
is he writing from Greece?
Shit's rough.
I don't understand what this is. He created his own Gmail account just to write to us. But Tell me what this means. Can you let me know what this means?
Okay.
This one's just for list. Dear Lord, woman, we're not sitting around playing records in your bedroom. Stop. What does that mean?
That's all he wrote?
Effective immediately. You will jump songs to a third of the way in before fading up. Stop.
Wait, what? Oh, is this like a telegram?
The sole exception is Spotlight on Del Amitri, where the intro is downright iconic. Stop. He doesn't want me to...
Wait, does he keep saying stop?
Say stop?
As if it's a telegram, even though he sent it from this Gmail account.
Does Stavros know who he's fucking with? Stavros, know. Here's what I want you to know. You will be sleeping tonight. You will think you have fallen into a deep slumber, and you will feel a cold hand on your neck. And it will be
Joey the hat.
Because we will make a call. Where is he from? Did he say where he's from?
He doesn't say, but I'll find out.
Stavros, you were in for a world of hurt.
That's so rude.
You know what? He clearly cares, and he's hearing the music. And there's a playlist, a Spotify playlist for Listler's Love Lockdown, Listler's Light Favorites, if you want to check that out, so that you can have it all the time and listen to the full song and do it on your own goddamn podcast.
But isn't he listening to this voluntarily?
That
sure
right.
is. And nobody's forcing him.
And it's free.
But guess what? When Joey the Hat gets a hold of him, he's going to play it real loud.
Let's see if he has any ears left after this shit.
Exactly.
Okay.
Joey the Hat just buries alive.
Oh, got it.
Shit.
Okay, keep going. Sorry.
Paul writes, anyway, we can get an update on Lil Nicky. Love that dude.
Listen, we've been trying. We've gotten lots of requests to have Lil Nicky back on. And maybe listen, we'll I hear from him.
Think we could do a call-in?
All the time. Yes. Yeah. Well, we talk every night before I go to sleep.
You and Lil Nicky?
Yep. We check in.
Okay.
Much like in When Harry Met Sally. Do you remember that whole sequence where they check in? Lil Nicky is currently going through a breakup.
Miss Toots, Lil Nicky was a transfer student that was sort of like a foreign exchange student, but he was from New Jersey. And he slept
from
on that aerobed with Maris for a while.
Yeah. So obviously we became very close. But yeah, mm-hmm. I'll ask him if he wants to call in. Next, I'm going to make this promise. Next episode, we will have a call-in from Lil Nicky.
Okay.
We'll make sure of it.
The next episode?
Next episode.
Okay.
All right.
We'll see what happens.
Okay. We'll see.
Hi, Marissa and Listler. Apologies in advance that this question is kind of a bummer, but I have a feeling you two might be the perfect one to ask. I'm 34 years old.
30 fierce years old.
Thank you.
Yeah, Beyonce.
And going through the breast cancer quote-unquote journey. P.S. Using that word still doesn't make it feel like a fun adventure.
No, it doesn't. Neither does battle. Fuck that shit.
And a divorce as well.
Oh, fuck. Man. You know what? Life really likes to serve it up hot and fresh.
I'm grateful that it looks like I'm going to be okay, but
of course
I've started
you are.
To think about dating whenever I come up for air. How do I broach the subject of my scarred and radiated tattoo? Let the guy find it on his own or talk about it ahead of time? Seems like kind of a boner killer. Also, let's be honest, I'm trying to have some fun, so the unveiling may be early on in a dating relationship. Thanks for any thoughts you may have, and thank you for also being a bright spot during tough stuff, mainly because hearing about Marissa's unfortunate body shape makes me feel better about my sad boob.
Okay. First of all, I want this person to follow me on Twitter, to tweet at me.
At Womp It Up Pod?
Yes, so I can follow them back and we can DM this shit offline because I have a lot to say.
Should they also follow
at
someone
what?
Else?
Oh, yes, St. Clair dot Jessica.
Okay.
Is it? No, at St. Clair Jessica. Is that it? Something like that. Follow that person.
They may already be following.
Because she's got a lot to say about the topic. But here is what I'm going to say. First of all, you are going to emerge from this experience like a phoenix from the ashes. Mm-hmm. And I am not joking when I tell you that you are going to be happier after this is done than you ever were pre-Big C. I know that seems insane, but what you are going to experience is what really very few people get to in their lives, which is that none of this bullshit matters. And everybody that is excess, who is fake, who is not living their authentic life, they fall away. So you're going to know instantly, is this a person I can roll with?
Is this a person I can become hashtag authentic with? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And when you find that person, so don't hold back. Mm-hmm. You tell them on the first date.
I think you're probably going to be wanting to talk about it if it's a person you connect
100%.
With.
100%. And you're going to say, this is what I went through and I survived. And that person is going to say, well, shit, I want to be this with this person even more because of it. Mm-hmm. And they are not going to be weirded out by your radiated boob. Mm-hmm. In fact, they're going to look at it as a fucking badge of honor. All right? And you're going to be keeping it right and tight in all areas.
Mm-hmm. Or if you're feeling a little sensitive about your top bits, just say, hey, let's hit the downstairs.
Exactly.
Let's hit that downstairs until our freak it can't handle it anymore.
Exactly.
All right,
but it takes a while for your mind
to
catch up with your body. So give yourself a minute. You know what I'm saying? Don't be like, oh, I don't feel great about myself yet.
Sit on the washing machine and freak it for a while.
Freak it as much as you want.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So we're here for you, and we're proud of you. And again, you get your shit together and know that you've got like 80 years ahead of you of the happiest days of your life. And I mean that. All right.
All right. Let's wrap it up. Thank you for your questions. If you have other questions, you can obviously reach out to us at wompupthejams@gmail.com.
Oh, is this in the middle enough for you, Stavros? God damn him.
All right, we just have a few minutes left for Spotlight On, so let me cue up something good here.
Okay, all right, Spotlight On. Miss Toots is a segment where we just look right at you. We put the spotlight on you.
Ooh.
Okay, and we find out what makes Miss Toots click and tick.
Or toot,
as it were.
What makes Miss Toots toot?
What the fuck?
Is this too up?
What the fuck? I don't know, man. With her, who knows what gets her going.
That's true. This could be... Ooh, she's really
hot,
rude.
Too.
She twerking?
Right. Yeah, let's... All right, this is Spotlight On Miss Judy Toots.
All right, Judy, I got to pick up the thread here, because here we are. Mm-hmm. You're in a relationship with Tony...
Joey the Hat. And also not a relationship.
Right, just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
I just want to get to the moment.
Sure.
Where you knew that your husband was being buried alive. Uh-huh. Because here's what I'm thinking to myself is you've got some time to dig that person up, right? Before they're dead.
I mean, listen, there I was in the kitchen.
Right. Not a stitch of clothes on you.
Just a dish towel on.
Right. And were you with Joey at the time?
No, Joey was in the back burying my husband.
Okay.
Alive.
Okay.
I was looking out the back window and I thought I saw the three men that I named.
Right. Right.
And my husband was gesturing, talking to them. I assume it was about $75,000.
Right.
And then they dug up a hole and they put him in it. Mm. And then they closed it up. Now, and then I ran out the front door screaming.
Now, why didn't you run towards him to dig him up?
Because I...
Oh, God.
Because what am I going to do?
Dig him up.
No, I don't know how to do that. I've never held a shovel in my life. I don't... You think my little hands could have saved him? There's no way.
Toots, do you ever lay in bed at night and think to yourself, what if?
Every night, I think, what if I had been wearing clothes? And I didn't just have a dish towel on.
Have you heard from Randolph from beyond?
No, but sometimes the light in my bathroom won't work. And I think...
That it's Randolph.
No, I just think it's got something to do with a circuit breaker or something.
Okay.
But I suppose if Randolph is out there and he's listening,
What would you say to him if you could say one more thing to him?
This is what you get for all that debt. What? What would you say?
Would you say, I'm sorry?
No, I didn't do it. Okay. But I mean, I am sorry. That's a terrible way to go. I agree. That's a bad way to go.
Well, I think we're the ones who are lucky because your energy is fun. And we just love having you around.
It is fun.
And you know what? Balances out Sam. And I think
Sam is such a downer sometimes.
Guys, there's some police here.
Oh. Ooh. No. Okay, here's what's going to happen.
What?
No. Not fun.
Should I stand up and wave my arms?
Nope. Listen to me. This is very important.
Okay.
Listler.
You're going to hop on my back.
Okay. No, what?
We're going up into the fence. What are you talking about?
What are you doing?
I'm going to take her on the road.
Oh, my God. Where did these cats come from?
Right, let's go.
Oh, my God.
Toot, toot.
Wait, okay. What's? Where am I going? What do I do? I'm taking my clothes off. I'm taking all my clothes off.
Everybody, clothes off. Get on the backs of the cats.
Officer Dan.
Get on the backs of these cats.
Get a load of these.
Oh, you're the decoy. Good, Marissa, good.
You like these? I'm swinging these around.
Hey, I'm Judy Toots. I'm in the witness protection room.
Go,
Judy,
go,
get on the cats.
Go.
Get on these cats.
Sam, take your dick out.
No.
I got this.
Sam, put him between my breasts. Let's see what's happening.
What are you doing?
Rub it in and out.
Do the outro!
Oh, God!
You gotta do the outro!
Wait, Sam's almost done! Oh God! They splooge! Sam, they splooge!
I'm too much!
No! Get up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you find out.
This has been an Earwolf production. Executive produced by Scott Aukerman, Chris Bannon, and Colin Anderson. For more information and content, visit earwolf.com.
Hey everybody, it's Paul Scheer.
And I'm Amy Nicholson.
And we have a brand new podcast called Unspooled, where we are watching the 100 greatest films of all time.
Voted on by the AFI. We're going to be starting at number one, Citizen Kane, jumping to number 100 with Ben-Hur, and doing films that we've never even watched before.
And we'll be talking to experts, whether it's a cinematographer or a stuntman. We're going to get behind these movies and figure out what makes them so great. So if you like the way this sounds, why don't you subscribe right now to Unspooled, wherever you listen to your podcasts.